All right, in this problem, we want to solve this equation 2 times tangent squared of t equals 3 times secant of t, and find all the solutions on the interval from 0 to 2 pi. So normally, when solving trig equations, we want to get everything on one side, if possible, and 0 on the other side. That way, we can factor, if we have more than one trig function like we do here. Now, even if we move the 3 secant t to the left by subtracting it from both sides like this, we still can't factor. We have tangents here and a secant here. However, we can put the tangent squared in terms of secant, because if we use the Pythagorean identity, which says tangent squared x plus 1 equals secant squared x, we can solve that for tangent squared. So we get tangent squared x is equal to secant squared x minus 1. And that could be helpful because then we would have all secants in our problem and we might possibly be able to factor. So I'm going to substitute that in here for tangent squared t. So we'll have secant squared t minus 1. That's all times 2. Then this minus 3 secant t equals 0. Now, in order to factor, I first need to simplify this, so let's go ahead and distribute the 2 out. And then I'm going to rearrange as well. I will have a negative 2, but I'm first going to write my minus 3 secant t, and then I'll write the minus 2, because that gets this into a standard order where we have a constant, a plain term, and then a squared term. And this looks a lot like a quadratic. So for factoring, I would use quadratic factoring techniques. So to get 2 secant squared t as our first term, one of the terms has got to be a 2 secant t, and the other term has to be a secant t. And in order to multiply it by to a 2 for our last term, one's got to be a 2 and one's got to be a 1. I'm going to put the 2 here and the 1 here. And 1 will have to be positive and 1 negative as well in order to multiply to negative 2. But if we put a negative here and a positive there, then if we were to refoil this, we'd have 2 secant squared t for our first term. The outside term would be negative 4 secant t, plus the inside term, 1 secant t, is negative 3 secant t, and then the last term is negative 2. So that does work. So now it's factored on the left. It's equal to 0 on the right, so we can set each factor equal to 0 and solve each of those two equations. Okay, so the first one, when we solve for secant of t, we're going to get secant of t equals negative 1/2. If you're uncomfortable with secant, you can, of course, switch this to cosine. And since cosine of t is its reciprocal, that would be cosine of t equals negative 2. Now, if we try to solve that equation, let's make some more room here. I'll draw a diagram to make this a little bit more clear. Cosine is negative, let's see, in the second and third quadrants here. And we would need to draw our triangle in such a way that x is 2, or negative 2, and r is 1. But if you think about it, that's actually an impossible triangle because the hypotenuse, or radius right there, can never be shorter than one of the lengths of the legs of the triangle. So your leg lengths in a right triangle must be shorter than your hypotenuse. So this equation here is going to have no solution. So let's turn our attention to this one. So we are looking for, where does secant of t equal 2? Or if we take its reciprocal, then that's where cosine of t would equal 1/2. So cosine is positive in the first and fourth quadrants, so we're going to have one solution up here in the first and one in the fourth. And we want to draw our triangle in such a way here that x is 1 and r is 2. Now that is a possible triangle. So if we want x to be 1, I've actually drawn those a little short here. Let's move this up. That would mean our leg length on the x-axis is the shortest, half that of the hypotenuse, so it would be up like this. And those are the side lengths of a 30, 60, 90 triangle. So that tells you that this angle right here is pi over 3. And this angle down here is the one that goes all the way around. So that angle, since the reference angle is pi over 3, that angle is 5 pi over 3. So we actually have two solutions here to this full equation, which are pi over 3 and 5 pi over 3.